Yehovah, please fill me with the Ruach HaKodesh, that I may speak your written words with boldness to those who listen. I ask all these things in Yeshua HaMashiach's name, amen. Start with the Shema, listen and obey. Children of Yah, pay careful attention and respond. Yehovah is our power and authority. Yehovah works in unity with himself, and you shall act upon your love to Yehovah with your power and authority, with your thoughts and mind, with your entire body, with all the muchness that you have. Proverbs 5 and 6. My son, pay attention to my wisdom. Incline your ear to my understanding, so that you will preserve discretion, and your lips keep watch over knowledge. For the lips of a woman who is a stranger drip honey. Her mouth is smoother than oil. But in the end, she is as bitter as wormwood, sharp as a double-edged sword. Her feet go down to death. Her steps lead straight to Sheol. She doesn't walk the level path of life. Her course wanders all over, but she doesn't know it. So now, children, listen to me. Don't turn away from what I am saying. Distance your way from her. Stay far from the door of her house, so that you won't give your vigor to others and your years to someone who is cruel. So strangers won't be filled with your strength. What you worked for won't go to a foreign house. Then, when your flesh and bones have shrunk, at the end of your life, you would moan. How I hated discipline. My whole being despised reproof. I ignored what my teachers said. I didn't listen to my instructors. I took part in almost every kind of evil, and the whole community knew it. Drink the water from your own cistern, fresh water from your own well. Let what your springs produce be dispersed outside, streams of water flowing in the streets. But let them be for you alone, and not for strangers with you. Let your fountain, the wife of your youth, be blessed. Find joy in her, a lovely deer, a graceful dawn, a graceful fawn. Let her breast satisfy you at all times. Always be infatuated with her love. My son, why be so infatuated with an unknown woman? Why embrace the body of a loose woman? For Yehovah is watching a man's ways. He surveys all his paths. A wicked person's own crimes will trap him. He will be held fast by the ropes of his sin. He will die from lack of discipline. The magnitude of his folly will make him totter and fall. My son, if you have put up security for your friend, if you have committed yourself on behalf of another, you have been snared by the words of your mouth, caught by the words of your own mouth. Do this now, my son, and extricate yourself. Since you put yourself in for your friend's power, go, humble yourself, and pester your friend. Give your eyes no sleep. Give your eyelids no rest. Break free like a gazelle from the hunter's trap, like a bird from the grip of the fowler. Go to the ant, you lazy bones. Consider its ways and be wise. It has no chief, overseer, or ruler. Yet it provides its food in summer and gathers its supplies at harvest time. Lazy bones, how long will you lie there in bed? When will you get up from your sleep? I'll just lie here a bit, rest a little longer. Just fold my hands for a little more sleep. And poverty comes marching in on you. Scarcity hits you like an invading soldier. A scoundrel, a vicious man, lives by crooked speech, winking his eyes, shuffling his feet, pointing with his fingers, with deceit in his heart. He is always plotting evil and sowing discord. Therefore, disaster suddenly overcomes him unexpectedly. He is broken beyond repair. There are six things Jehovah hates, seven which he detests: a haughty look, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that plots wicked schemes, feet swift in running to do evil, a false witness who lies with every breath, and him who sows strife among brothers. My son, obey your father's command and don't abandon your mother's teaching. Bind them always on your heart. Tie them around your neck. When you walk, they will lead you. When you lie down, they will watch over you. And when you wake up, they will talk with you. For the mitzvah is a lamp, Torah is light, and reproofs that discipline are the way of life. They keep you from an evil woman, from a loose woman's seductive tongue. Don't let your heart lust after her beauty, or allow her glance to captivate you. The price of a whore is a loaf of bread, but the adulteress is hunting for a precious life. Can a man carry fire inside his shirt without burning his clothes? Can a man walk barefoot on hot coals without scorching his feet? So is he who has sex with his neighbor's wife. Anyone touching her will be punished. A thief is not despised if he steals only to satisfy his appetite when hungry. But even he, if caught, must pay back sevenfold. He must have to give up all the wealth that he owns. He who commits adultery lacks sense. He who does it destroys himself. He will get nothing but blows and contempts, and his disgrace will not be wiped away. For jealousy drives a man into rage. He will show no mercy when he takes revenge. He will not accept compensation. He'll refuse every bribe, no matter how large. And with the Aaronic blessing, Jehovah will kneel before you presenting gifts, and he will guard you with a hedge of protection. Jehovah will illuminate the wholeness of his being toward you, bringing order, and he will provide you with love, sustenance, and friendship. Jehovah will lift up the wholeness of his being and look upon you, and will set in place all you need to be whole and complete. Amen.